If there is no evidence of active tuberculosis being present, then Global Health will advise the embassy of this and the ban will be lifted. But if there is evidence of an active TB infection, then the applicant will be required to undergo treatment under the supervision of a specialist physician whom the panel doctor will refer the applicant to. This will involve daily medication and possibly injections for 6 to 9 months. The treatment will continue until the applicant can be diagnosed as being free of the infection. And please note that Global Health has one job to do, and it is to ensure that visa applicants meet the health requirements for visas and keep out those who do not. They won't hurry up, and they won't keep you or us or even the Australian Embassy informed about what's happening. Will this affect the visa application? Will the visa be refused? If all things go well, then no, this will not lead to a refusal. This will delay the decision until the applicant is free of the disease. And then, if everything else is okay with the application, the visa will be granted. However, you need to keep up the treatment and keep in contact with the doctor. If you change your phone number or fail to turn up to appointments, then the doctor will inform the department that you still have active TB and you will face a refusal. This happened to a client of ours once, and it came as a terrible shock. So if this happens to you, don't panic. Don't get all upset. Be grateful that the disease was diagnosed, because it can be horribly debilitating. Diagnosis means treatment can happen, and the applicant will get better. Doctors in Australia are not accustomed to seeing TB in their patients, and it may go undiagnosed for years had it not been picked up this way. And try to understand that this is the price you pay to keep horrible diseases like this out of Australia. You can't have it both ways. Thank you.